Yeah, Stella lived you up. Hello, Stella. How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
I am well. Can you tell these people who is the artist and what is the song that you will be defending?
Okay, the artist is a Canadian group called Before Four, because there's three of them.
Okay.
And, and the song name is Go Go.
Go Go. Okay, so Before Four. Go, please.
Wow.
Yeah, so Before Four. So 1999, Toronto, Canada. Twins Ryan and Dan Kowalski got together with their buddy, a guy by the name of Onad Einbender, and they formed a boy band, a Canadian boy band. And as Stella said, they called it B44 because three comes before four. And they got signed pretty quickly. They started cranking out all them Canadian boy band hits, and they started dressing in a way that is almost unexplainable. It's like a funhouse mirror or something. You know, I can't make heads or tails of it. The group had a couple of hits in Canada. They broke up in 2004. Where is he? I thought they were triplets, but one of these is not an identical twin. And that's Einbender. And I... Okay, real quick. This band... this band is really hard to find information about on the internet. They're called B44. And these next things are things that came up in Google higher, which is the MTA B44 bus route, which is a local service for Sheepshead Bay in Williamsburg, which is very probably very convenient. It goes on Nostrum Avenue, if you wanted to know. Also, I found a lot of, when I was looking for pictures, I found a lot of pictures of a 1971 BSA B44 before I came across any pictures of these dudes. After I would look at the picture, I'd go back and just look at that, because it's nice looking. Anyway, so in 2004, the group finally broke up. You know, they had their hits, they moved on. Einbender, he left public life. I think this is him now, but I cannot confirm it. I think it's him. He left public life, but he went on to invent this product called the Boom Phones, and it's headphones that have speakers on the outside, so you can use it. It's actually a really good idea, so kudos to that guy. Okay, and then these two clowns, they decided not to leave music behind, and their names are Ryan and Dan, so they formed a new group called Ryan and Dan. You can see Ryan and Dan in Las Vegas these days opening up for Shania Twain. So things did work out for the guys of people before. And in this picture, I was like, oh, wow, they've really matured. But then I found this one. I'm like, you can still see it. You know what I mean? Like, you can still kind of see it. But we're going to play a clip of the song. And then Stella is going to defend the song. Okay, let's play that clip.
Night. Oh, feeling good.
holy. Stella, here is the clicker, and you have 5 minutes to defend this song.
All right. Pete, could you continue playing the song starting at 1:30?
Absolutely.
Thanks, Pete.
Hold on. Let's hit it.
Video and think to yourself, was this made exactly at the turn of the century? And you'd be correct. See, this was the turn of the century for Canada. oh, let's go back. So the beauty of the song and video is that it's a time capsule. You've never heard this song before, I guarantee it. And yet, it feels like you've heard it before. It's got a familiar flavor, kind of like Oreo and cream betweens. Or maybe Kung Fu Panda and Chop Kick Panda. Even say, I can't believe it's not butter, and unbelievable, this is not butter. Honestly, it sounds kind of like a bad Amazon review. Unbelievable, this is not butter. I will not be referring to one star. So this song specifically, I think, is pan-genre. Some could argue that it's pop. Others might argue that it's country rock. Some might say ear rape. But for me, I call it Canadian Y2K. And I'll spare you the dance breakdown of the video. Actually, I won't. Pete, could you play it? Starts at 2:23. Good job, Pete. Thank you. So, what I wanted to say about this part is, it's like their producer had a bet with another music producer as to see who could use as many sound effects on the soundboard as possible in a song and still have it be a top hit. Which is true. This song was a fave videos of the 2000s. and if you pay attention, the boys are actually even whispering the entire song in addition to singing it. You can hear it in the background, and you can hear it most obviously near the end at around 4 minutes in. These Canadian gentlemen, and yes, they're Canadian, at 1:36, you can hear the proof. Before you move, don't move and get. And yes, they're gentlemen, as you can see in their other smash hit, Get Down, around 2 minutes and 2 seconds in. And I defend the song because I first heard it only a year and a half ago, and it was horrible. And I started listening to it over again to see if it was really that bad, and it was. But then I started listening to it ironically, and then I ended up liking it. So that's my argument.
All right. When you played the clip of the second video, I was like, oh yeah, nothing problematic here, no problem. Yeah. Everybody checks out, and if you listen real close in the background, you go, sorry, after every verse. All right, judges, who believes that, or audience rather, who believes that our judges made a more compelling argument in this case?
Woo! Really? Honestly, it's really. Okay, she made a good argument.
Judges, you just got the shit kicked out of you. Who believes that a better argument was made by Stella? Woo! Oh, that was great. Thank you so much, Stella. Thank you, everybody, for coming. We'll be back third.